akhandamandalakaram vyaptam yena characharam tatpadam darsitam yena tasmai shri gurave namah. In Kriya Yoga, Guru Pranam technique is taught as Master. Guru Pranam means bowing down to Masters. Here in this technique, we bow, we place different lords up the traditional Hindu practices in different energy centers and bow down to them. This technique is a mixture of devotion, concentration, breath technique, bandha and mudras. Though we don't find this technique in all the lineages of the Kriya Yoga, but those lineages, they have their origin to the ashram of Sri Yukteswar ji at Puri. They almost all practice this technique. Here, a practitioner establishes Lord Ganapati at the first center, that is the Muladhara Chakra. Ganapati is having a sthulatanu, big body. This means this represents earth element. And the big elephant head Lord, who is having a big trunk, this represents nose, a big nose. That means this is the smell quality. We know that the earth element is represented by the smell quality. So first we establish the Lord of earth element and the Lord of smell, Ganesha, in Muladhara Chakra and bow down to them. Then second center, at Swadhisthana, we establish Devi. We know that Ganesh guards the Devi, the door of the Devi. So at the second center, there is Bhagavati Mahakali, who is having an emerging tongue. Emerging tongue represents taste element, taste. This is water element and taste quality. Lord of water element and taste is Bhagavati Mahakali. Then at the third center at Manipura, we establish Bhagavan Surya Narayan, the sun god. It is said, Chakshu Suryo Ajayata. Sun is the eye. This is fire element and vision. So Lord of fire element vision is sun god. And we establish sun god in the third center. Then coming to the fourth center, Anahata, here we established Lord Vishnu. This is air element and sensation, touch. Air is responsible for sustention of the life, and sustention is the Lord of sustention is Vishnu. So we establish Vishnu at the fourth center, the Lord of air element and sensation of touch. And in the fifth center, that is Vishuddha, we establish Bhagavan Shankar. This is ether element. And the quality of ether element is sound. We know that Shankar is always having a dambur on his hand. That means representing sound. Sound is the cause of the creation. From ether onwards, the creation has been started. Then after establishing the five gods in the five centers, we establish Prana Krishna at the Agyachakra. This is generally referred as Krishna consciousness, or Christ consciousness, we can say. So here we establish at the sixth center Krishna, and the practitioner establishes his Ishtadeva, or the Supreme Father, at the seventh center, Sahasrara. In this way, we bow down to seven masters. Nowadays, we find some people are establishing the lineage of gurus in the different centers. That means their immediate guru in the first center, then Parama Guru in the second center, Paratpara Guru in the third center. This is also correct, because in that way we bring emotional devotion to Guru. So either we can establish different gods, as has been done from the ancient days, or we can establish our immediate masters in different centers. As we know, we are all emotional beings. So that is why here in this technique there is mixture of devotion and breath practices. And in initial days, the devotion helps a lot for progress. To understand this technique, one must understand the yoga mudra technique of traditional hatha yoga. In traditional hatha yoga, in yoga mudra technique, one sits either in padmasana and siddhasana and then bows down. While bowing down, he exhales. Then along with the exhalation bows down, then stays there for a period, and along with the inhalation comes off. That is the traditional yoga mudra technique in hatha yoga practice done before the meditation. But here in Kriya Yoga, what we do is we first sit either in a siddhasana or padmasana. That means the posture of siddhas or the posture, the lotus posture. Because it is said in Yoga Kundalini Upanishad that ekam siddhasanam proktam dityam kamalasana. But those who cannot sit in siddhasana or padmasana, they can sit in sukhasana, the easy cross-legged posture. And then they have to take long and deep breath from Muladhara to Sahasrara. After and long and deep breath, the practitioner has to retain the breath, hold the breath and bow down. Then sit up and exhale from Sahasrara to Muladhara. In this way, what happens? The capacity of lungs to hold air is increased. Chest cavity is expanded and there is pressure on the diaphragm. While bowing down, the abdominal cavity compresses. And this gently massages all the visceral organs and they get abundant blood supply. This is one aspect. Another aspect is, while bowing down and coming up, again and again, the joints of the vertebrae, they got the exercise and they are relaxed. And the spinal cord becomes flexible. In this way, if spinal cord becomes flexible, then the life force can ascend from Muladhara to Sahasrara easily. So this is the preparation to make the spine flexible. Again and again bowing down, one will feel heat in the vertebral column. So that this helps in removing the obstacles inside the spinal column. So this is the basic thing in this technique. So that where we are having bandha and mudra, but we are reversing the yoga mudra technique so that we get better effect to our visceral organs, to the diaphragm, and having more capacity to our lungs. Then moreover, devotion to the gods or devotion to Guru helps better in concentration. Now what we do is that first concentrate in Muladhara Chakra for a period. Those who are devotional in nature, they can imagine Lord Ganesha. Otherwise, those who are not devotional in nature simply concentrate at that point. And after concentrating for a period, take a long and a deep breath from Muladhara to Sahasrara. Hold the breath, bow down, then sit up, then exhale. And one will find for the new practitioners that their face will become completely red because there is abundant blood supply to the head region and to the brain. Then he moves to the second center. Similarly, establishing Bhagavati Mahakali in the second center, the same technique is repeated. Then coming to the third, establishing Sun God there, the same technique is repeated. Then coming to the fourth, establishing Lord Vishnu there, then the same technique is repeated. Then coming to the fifth one, establishing Bhagavan Shankar there, the same technique is repeated. Then coming to the sixth one, establishing Lord Krishna there. Or if you are a Christian, you can establish Lord Jesus Christ there. Then the same technique is repeated. Then coming to the seventh center, we establish the Supreme Father, Paramapita, or our short deity, Ishtadev. And then the same technique is repeated. So in this way, the technique is performed. And we find that we have concentration, practice in each centers. We have long and deep breath practice with each centers. We have mudra, and this is all the breathing is done with Jalandhar Bandha. The chin gently locked. So we have Bandha. So in this way, this gives the very foundation and the preparations for the further higher practices in Kriya Yoga. Though we find a similar practice in Sri Vidya technique, they establish five Shambhus in the five centers: Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, Maheshwara, Sadashiva. And then at the sixth center they establish Tripura Sundari, and at the seventh Param Shiva. Similarly, in different traditions, we find that the establishment of different gods, according to their love, their devotion, they do. But I do not know whether other techniques, other systems, they have such a bowing down technique, though bowing down like the form of Yoga Mudra has been done. But this is far more effective than the Yoga Mudra technique. And so that entire spinal column becomes flexible and becomes eligible to hold the life force that can ascend to the top. Oh.